Welcome on this IT Live. I'm Jan Michalewski. My name is Jan Michalewski. I'm the product owner in PGS software. And I would like you to tell you a little bit about the benefits of involving your software partner in your projects. Okay, so let's take a look at the agenda. Firstly, I would like to briefly remind what is the product owner role in the Scrum team. Secondly, I would like to show how this role evolved in the last time in terms of relation between software houses and client. And at the end, basing on my experience, I will show how the software house can support their clients. So let's skip to the first point, the product owner in the Scrum team. Yeah, and according to the Scrum guide, the product owner is responsible for maximizing the value of the product, resulting in the work on the Scrum team. It means that he's accountable for the effective product backlog management, which includes product goal, creating and clearly communicating product backlog items, ordering product backlog items, and ensuring that the product backlog is transparent, visible, and understood. Yeah, that is theory. But very often from it seems to be that this role is underrated, yes, and it's crucial from my experience, and it's very important to have this role in the organization, and that because that role focuses on all aspects of the products, yes, in terms of product vision, customer needs, revenue streams. And if there is no such role, the organizations are focusing more on delivering features and very often miss the important questions. For example, how the product is used by the end users, what features are really crucial for the users and what really not matter so much, and what value it brings to the users. Yes, so in this questions, this role focus, yes, not on features, but on these questions. And so what is the role of software product owner and how it changed in the last time? Yeah, because it is not obvious that that software house delivers PO to the client. Yeah. So in this traditional approach to cooperation with software house, the PO is rather on the client side. Yeah, very often there is always a role of business analyst, which is an intermediate role, and the business analyst generally is responsible for communicating the client needs to the team. Of course, it could be more than one team for each product owner, yeah, from the software house. And three reasons why it could be ineffective. Yeah, sometimes it means that the team focus more on dates and feature over the results. There is a long feedback loop between dev team and the client, and also the little interaction between dev team and the end users. Yeah, but in the last few months, we observed the switch in the approach. What is the source of this switch? A lot of companies transformed themselves from project-oriented to product-centric organization. Yes, so it is one source, and the second is post-pandemic trends. Why? The companies transform from project-oriented to product-centric. I think there is speed of change, yes, that requires a shortening of the distance between developers and decisions made for the product. And also the data is now crucial to the decisions, yes. So in this product-oriented organization, product owners focusing more on problem solving and product discovery rather than developing features. There is more autonomy for the teams. As an example, very often the teams can choose the software delivery method they want to have for their own. It could be Scrum for one team in the organization, and for the other team in the same organization could be Kanban, for example. And there is also a dedicated product owner in the team in place of traditional business analyst role. Yeah, so this is this change. Also, I've mentioned about this post-pandemic trends, which really accelerate the transformation projects. Yes, digitalization within the organizations. Yes, so that means that the companies rely on service software houses more heavily, and also share some risk and rewards with their service providers. Okay, and when we get back to this cooperation between product owner and the software house. So the product owner is not necessary from the, on the client side. Yes, it could be, but it can be also the software house product owner. And he cooperates with the outsourced team or extended dev team. Yes, it means the team that is a mixed of clients developers and the software house developers. And in his work with the client, he focuses more on objectives and leading metrics than features. Yes, so that is this switch and this change. Okay, so what is in real the benefits of software house product owners? As we know, this, the product owners have a different skills, different approach to their work. Some of them focus more on the vision and are skilled and have competences in building this. Some of them focusing on collaboration, some of them on experiments. Of course, very often there is a mix of these different skills which makes the product owner great. And how we can position the software product owner in this. I think, yeah, from my experience, the software product owner can be effective in drives the product discovery process on the one hand, and on the other in measuring results from this iterative development process. Yeah, so these two elements seems to worth highlighting. How it works in practice? In product discovery, thanks to the technological shift in terms of remote working and communication method, it's really easy now to organize the customer interviews. It's not the problem to organize these interviews with people all around the world, yes? Even for the end users that are not very skilled with, some tools. Now, a lot of people are familiar with tools like Zoom or Teams, yes, so it's not the problem. And the product owners based in Poland, for example, organize runs a session with people from Philadelphia, LA, or Melbourne, yes. And of course, as the result of this discovery of these interviews, they use the tools like personas or customer journey canvas to provide the better understanding of the user needs. Very often, the software PO supports their clients in crafting the best strategy, yes, for their product during the workshop with tools like business model canvas or value proposition canvas. And it is very useful for the new products and startups. Yes, it can be very, very useful. So the one is the product discovery. Secondly, I've mentioned measuring results. Yes, so now the data is so important. We know this. Yeah, but it in this area can be very tricky. Yes, it is really a challenge to find good metrics to measure it. It also requires a lot of knowledge to analyze the data, and very often we have a lot tons of data, but not a lot of knowledge from this. And this part is very crucial from this new approach, yeah, because the decisions, the product decisions should be done on base of the data, yes. So the software product owners have the exposure on different tools using in gathering and measuring product. As example, we use the Google Analytics mainly for the web products, yeah. When there is a need to merge data from different domains, from desktop apps, web apps, and also in cloud technology, sometimes use the Azure Insights. When is Amplitude is also the tool that we use in A/B tests, yes, mainly for the web apps. So from the also we have the exposure on different project and some experience how what is the best tool, yeah, for what purpose. So that is one, and of also we use the frameworks, yes, that exist and are very useful. For example, very often the HERD framework, yes, which the framework invented by the Google and could be used to measure the overall UX experience. Yeah, in certain project we use it. Also, the other very popular framework is the Pirates Metrics. Yeah, and this one we rather use when we need to measure metrics for the new product in the company portfolio or for the startup success, yes. So it is something also that we have exposure on. Yeah, and that's this these two elements, I think, it's product discovery and measuring success is something that really software product owner could support the organization. What are the challenges? Yeah, sometimes because there are sometimes the clients fear of losing the control on the product. Yes, that's why hesitate and they want to delegate this responsibility to the software product owner. Yes, so it is the fear that we know, but how can we solve it? Yeah, so the of course the software house PO can report directly to the product manager or director or head of product within the client organization. Yes, so in that way he is in very close communication with him, with other stakeholders in the organization. So that's why it can work. And also very often the product owner is the member of the product team and cooperates with other POs from the client organization. Yes, so as the member of the team, he has the same mindset, yes, same approach to to the product, and of course able to decide in a good way. So it can be a hybrid team, yeah, with PS from the software house and from the client. Yeah, to sum up what we've said, yeah, I think today the software house product owner supports effectively product-centric transformation. Yes, yeah? So when the company know that he must to deal with this challenge, it's good to consider the software house product owner. These owners drive the product discovery and metrics, which are essential in creating a good product, and delegating some of these jobs doesn't mean loss of the control, yes, because we work as a team and part of the team of the client team, so it's not so bad in this area. I think that's all what I want to say. I hope it was useful, this presentation. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks a lot, and see you in the projects.